Good evening. Today, the woman who speaks for the President of the United States said she cannot rule out the possibility that her boss, the President, is on tape using the N-word, the same word that the President just last night said does not exist in his vocabulary, never has. Here's the question Sarah Sanders was asked today and her response, which has been making headlines ever since.
Can you stand at the podium and guarantee the American people they'll never hear Donald Trump utter the N-word on a recording in any context?
I can't guarantee anything, but I can tell you that the president addressed this question directly.
We'll play the entire exchange in a moment, but first let's just review how we got to that moment. On CBS This Morning today, Omarosa Manigault Newman continued her book tour talking about another recording she made. It's purportedly a conference call from October of 2016 about the possible existence of the tape of the president using the N-word during his time on The Apprentice. Manigault Newman is on the call, so are campaign aide Jason Miller, though he's not heard in the recording released by CBS. So is Katrina Pearson, as well as Lynn Padden, who was an assistant to Eric Trump at the time. She joins us shortly tonight. On the call, there's talk of damage control and whether Mr. Trump ever used the racial slur. Lynn Padden is heard saying that she asked Mr. Trump about using the word, and he said no. Later, Pearson says this. Now, last night, Katrina Pearson denied the phone call happened. Today, she says she was saying he said it as a way to appease Manigault Newman and basically get her off the phone. Barely 30 minutes after the story hit this morning, the president responded on Twitter. When you give a crazed, crying lowlife a break and give her a job at the White House, I guess it just didn't work out. Good work by General Kelly for quickly firing that dog. This was just the latest in a series of tweets about Manigault Newman. Once again, Sarah Sanders was asked about the president's language, particularly as it sometimes relates to African Americans he's criticizing. Here's what she said.
Look, the president, this has absolutely nothing to do with race and everything to do with the president calling out someone's lack of integrity. The idea that you would only point a few of the things that the president has said negative about people that are minorities, the fact is the president's an equal opportunity person that calls things like he sees it. He always fights fire with fire, and he certainly doesn't hold back on doing that across the board.
Now, whatever you think of that answer, just take a moment and consider this. Under ordinary circumstances, the president calling a former high-level advisor, an African-American woman, a dog, might be material enough for a press briefing. But there was a lot more today, and I want to play it for you, as well as the questions leading up to it, so you get the full context and the full impact.
Ask the president if he's ever used the N-word.
The president addressed that question directly via Twitter. I'd refer you back to him. I can certainly say I've never heard him use that term or anything similar.
Have you asked him directly, Sarah?
The president, I didn't have to because he addressed it to the American people all at one time.
Why haven't you asked him directly?
Again, the president answered that question directly on Twitter earlier today.
Can you stand at the podium and guarantee the American people they'll never hear Donald Trump utter the N-word on a recording in any context?
I can't guarantee anything, but I can tell you that the president addressed this question directly. I can tell you that I've never heard it.
I can't guarantee anything, she said, but she's never heard it, which again is odd because the president just last night said that he could. At Mark Burnett TV called to say that there are no tapes of The Apprentice where I use such a terrible and disgusting word as attributed by wacky and deranged Omarosa. I don't have that word in my vocabulary and never have. She made it up. Not in his vocabulary, he says. Not ever, he says. The president's tweet seems pretty definitive, at least definitive enough for his press secretary to give it the kind of definitive statement like these she's repeated for past presidential tweets.
I would say that his tweet speaks for itself there. I think the president's statement via Twitter today is extremely clear. I don't have anything to add beyond the statement itself. I think that statement speaks for itself. There's nothing to add.
Well, she could have said that today, but she did not. And perhaps that speaks for her and for itself. More now from the White House. CNN Jeff Zeleny was at today's briefing, joins us for that. So it's interesting for all the times that Sarah Sanders has been willing to essentially stick her neck out for the president with a full stop answer. She didn't do that this time.
She didn't, Anderson. That was one of the surprising things to me, at least, because repeatedly under, asked again and again about this, she said the same answer, I can't guarantee that. And she knew, of course, that that would be the headline coming out of this, that she can't guarantee it. But think of all the radio interviews. I mean, thousands and thousands of hours of radio interviews the president has done, all the recordings he has done going into The Apprentice, other things. There could be a tape somewhere. So perhaps that's what she was thinking when she said, I can't guarantee it. But she certainly was not definitive at all. And in many other times, she has been. So it was curious, at least, in that regard.
And Jeff, is the White House still saying that the president's description of Manigault Newman as a dog is much ado about nothing?
They are indeed. And you heard Sarah Sanders talk about it there. She basically said he's happy to insult anyone. He's happy to insult anyone of any race who he doesn't agree with. He said that the president believes that she lacks integrity. Keep in mind, of course, he hired her. He brought her on here in the first place. He's been a longtime friend of hers. But the reality is the White House repeatedly said it's not racist. You know, only the president knows what's in his heart when he said that. He has called numerous people dogs repeatedly. There's a long list of former rivals he's called dogs, other things, but never as a sitting president has he called a former staffer, certainly a former African-American high-ranking staffer here, a dog. That's what he called Omarosa, of course, this morning.
And I understand that the Manigault Newman is claiming that she was interviewed by special counsel Robert Mueller. Do we know if that's even true?
We have her word on that, and that's the only word, because the special counsel, of course, is the only person in this town, I believe, who has not commented on this case. But we do know, at least talking to White House officials here, that while she was at least at the White House, she was not interviewed. She was not asked to sit down with them. But of course, she was fired last December. So she writes in her book that she was contacted by the FBI in February of 2018. So after that, if she sat down with him, that, of course, is something that she would have a record of and have a understanding of. It's hard to imagine that she would lie about that specifically when it's so verifiable. But of course, the special counsel's office never comments on who they interview. So it is her word at this point. But Anderson, so much of this simply is her word. Of course, a lot of unverified claims in there.
Yeah.
But a lot of claims on tape as well, Anderson.
Jeff Zeleny, thanks very much.